In the 2000s, investors in the US and abroad looking for a low-risk, high-return investment started throwing their money at the US housing market. The price of homes in the US was going up and up and up. Well, this was a bubble.
Everyone who buys a house now in New York or Miami or in San Diego assumes that the price will just keep going up and up and up. And that's what you call a bubble. That's because it doesn't happen.
I just feel, look, I have a different take on this. I think the housing boom is a tremendous plus for middle-income people, for low-income people. You're not going to have a housing bubble go bust when the unemployment rate is low and the economy is growing at 3-4%.
Bubbles have an annoying tendency to burst, and this one did. People just couldn't pay for their incredibly expensive houses or keep up with their ballooning mortgage payments. Borrowers started defaulting, which put more houses back on the market for sale. But there weren't buyers, so supply was up, demand was down, and home prices started collapsing. As prices fell, some borrowers suddenly had a mortgage for way more than their home was currently worth. Some stopped paying. That led to more defaults, pushing housing prices down further. As this was happening, the big financial institutions stopped buying subprime mortgages, and subprime lenders were getting stuck with bad loans. By 2007, some really big lenders had declared bankruptcy.
We're having a really, really interesting and fairly scary financial crisis. You can fairly call it a financial crisis. We don't know how badly it will affect the real economy yet, but it's a very real disruption. And in August of this year, we had a return of financial conditions strongly reminiscent of September 1998. And as before, there was what it looked like a pretty speedy resolution. And things improved, and then they got worse again.
I am declaring the recession debate is over. No recession out there, nada, not happening. There ain't no recession. That's the theme of this show. Subject closed as far as I'm concerned.
What about Don Luskin and Dave Gidlitz over at Trend Macro? Because actually, when you look at their shop, it may not be as large as the other shops. In my view and in our viewers' view, they have had a very good track record on this non-recession economy, which one might even call the boom. One might even call it the Bush boom, including the supply-side tax cuts. Year-to-date, of the 10 major sectors in the S&P index, only two of them are down. But you know what? Everything else has made great money. Energy plus 27, basic materials 17, utes 14, tech 13. Yep. I mean, if you had hit any of the others besides those, or if you had held, for example, the spiders or the broad-based exchange-traded funds, you'd done okay, wouldn't you?
You sure would, and what does that tell you? That's the magic of diversification. So just hang in there, and don't let the media and the pundits or Goldman Sachs' economists get you too pessimistic by just focusing on those tiny little areas that are doing badly, because overall, the economy's doing great and the market's doing
great. Is there a Santa Claus rally left, or are we just going to have to wait till the new year?
I think there's going to be a rally through the end of the year. There's nothing fundamentally wrong with the economy. The stocks are cheap. They've just been beaten up mercilessly. And it's time for some rebound and then some.
All the haters want a chick. Tight, no snake, just bought a Cadillac.